Yo, what is up, YouTube, your fan, football fan, 2233 here, bringing you episode number 30 of my Road to Premier League series. And as you can see here, we already have October the 5th, so that's pretty damn great. We're already like 10 games into the season, and I'm really happy with the result of that so far. As you can see here, our goalkeeper has gone up by a couple of levels, I believe. Maybe only one, I'm not quite sure. All I know that is he has been fantastic during the whole season, and I really appreciate him. Having him down in the goal, and we go into the game here against Leyton Orient, and as you can see, they have a red card to Griffith, so I hope that was their starting striker. And here in the 20th minute, Hackett crosses it in, and Oduro smashes it into the back of the net. And first of all, I wanna apologize for my voice and my nose running and all that. I hope you can live with that, because I'm getting sick, I can feel that. But anyways, let's just move on with this commentary. As you can see, Oduro using his pace, fake shot, smashing it into the back of the net. Really good goal there from Dominic Oduro. And here in the 19th minute, the Montagnac will also get his second goal of the game. A nice right-footed shot down in the bottom right corner. So two goals by the Montagnac and two goals by Dominic Oduro. That's what you call a successful match. And yeah, the referee blows the whistle, and I win 4-0, I'm sorry. And Ishmael de Montagne gets the Man of the Match award. As you can see here, we got the career 10 match milestone. And here I have a couple of players leaving on international duty, but for me it didn't really matter. So here, in this game against Carlisle United, it's a paint trophy. I could go with my strongest 11, because there was a long break after, but I choose to not go with the starting 11. I could, but I didn't, so instead I took Segovia in and Asokyu in to the free agents assigned in the last season, Poponi out, and in with the Gatsev, in with Akefemwa, and also in with Henok Mukendi, because Henok Mukendi is in a pretty good shape at the moment, but he's still not my starting striker, and I believe he is happy about not being that. But anyways, here Mukendi scored after a corner kick in 2-0, and that is pretty great. And here Tulsa gives it a smack just outside the box, and it just goes in via the keeper's hands. And here I can film one crossing it in for Henok Mukendi, who just has to put it into the back net. No big problem for a great striker as he is. And here in the 57th minute, Akinfenwa will score a great goal. 58th minute. And Selkie had a nice shot, but the keeper saved it twice after a header from Henok Mukendi. But then at last, Segovia came and he snuffed out and scored the goal. That's also how the game went. I won 5-0, so a pretty comfortable victory. And Mukendi with two goals, and also Tozer with one, and Akinfenwa with one. Or was it only 4-0? I can't really remember right now, but it doesn't matter if it was 4 or 5-0. As you can see here, we have played 11 league games, and I have 33 points, and I have already a 7-point lead. So that's pretty great, and I'm looking forward to play more games in this season. As you know, I still have 35 league games remaining, because there are 24 teams in this league, and I have to meet every one of them two times, excluding me. So there's 23 teams that I need to play two times, so that gives 46 games, and I will already played 11, so only 35 more to go. I know that sounds like a lot and all that, but it's only gonna take like 6, 12, 18, 24, it's only gonna take 4 weeks before I'm in the NPL Championship, and then another 4 weeks, so in eight to ten weeks I should be in the Premier League. Actually, doesn't that sound pretty great? It does in my ears. I think it sounds pretty great there. So I'm hoping that that I maybe can come in the Premier League as fast as I want to, because it could be really awesome to play in the Premier League. And as you can see here, I had some youth players, but I couldn't sign them because I didn't have the budget for it, and I couldn't request funds out of the transfer window. So that was a bit unfortunate, but that's the way it is. And I just said, you know what, it doesn't really matter anymore. I'm just gonna go into this match against, I can't really remember the name of the team, but I know the next match, the first match in the episode 31, will be against Walsall United. So look out for that. It will be out tomorrow sometime. I'm not quite sure when tomorrow, I just know it will be tomorrow. And it was against Rotherham United, or Rotherham City, I'm not quite sure. And as you can see here, they start the game off in the 25th minute with a nice volley shot to make it a 1-0 event. But in the 87th minute, Emmanuel Pony will come and he will smash it into the back of the net. And here, in the 19th minute, I get a bit lucky. Oduro suddenly using his pace, stops up, plays it. It was for Paponi, but he jumped over the Raps and could take it and he could smash it into the back of the net. So we're pretty damn lucky to win this match. 2-1-2 late goals, but my squad has the morale. They really have to have the morale to fight themselves back, even though they are in very sticky situation. So yeah, I just hope you liked this video, and if you did, it a like and a comment, and also if you subscribe to my channel, it is also appreciated. Yeah, and I will see you all later.